Ladies and gentlemen, that's a picture wrap on Bill Skarsgård that's given to him.
I remember when we wrapped the first movie, the last day of the shoot, feeling like we did something special here.
Cheers, guys. Cheers.
But you don't dare to trust that feeling because you're like, oh, what if you're wrong? What if this is a disaster? And what if your performance is a disaster? But then it shattered every expectation I think anyone had on it.
Obviously, it's a big deal to see that your vision succeeded. It also gives you a lot of confidence for the bets that you're making on the second one, because you know what works and what doesn't.
Andy and I were talking about potential ideas for the sequel even when we were doing the first one, because we knew that we were going to do the second one.
And action. Yeah, that's beautiful. But chapter two. I always wanted to make a scarier movie and crank up the horror aspects of it.
It was strange because I'd been away from Pennywise for almost 2 years. And then Andy wanted me to do a test for a VFX motion capture thing. Been away from the character for so long. It's gonna be strange just like to go right back into it. And I got the scene like the night before, and Andy's on Skype because he's already in Toronto for pre-production. And he goes, you know, okay, action, you know.
And action!
Pennywise is just ever-present and just, like, exploded out of me. I was surprised how much of him was just still there, because the first movie was so much for me was to figure out who the character was.
With Bill, he put so much of him into the creation. The nuances in his face, the spark in his eyes. I really love sitting down with him and talking for hours about the character and the possibilities.
27 years, I dreamt of you. I craved you. Oh, I missed you, waiting for this very moment. Time to flow.
In my preparation for the role the first time, I applied all these sort of crazy psychology to the character. There's a lot of scenes with Pennywise where it's just a physicality or a very technical thing.
It's a tremendously physical performance. He works really hard. It's just amazing. It's balletic. It's so good.
The scenes that I tend to really prefer are the ones where you could, you know, be a little bit more... Subtle's the wrong word for this character, I think, but where you can be a little bit more nuanced, maybe. There's definitely more of those scenes in this one than there were in the first one.
A little closer. One. Two.
You okay?
Good job.
The Pennywise that we meet in the second movie is different from the book. He's very defensive in the book. He's offensive when they're kids, and when they come back, he's sort of trying to scare them off. So that shows weakness instantly, because he obviously doesn't want them to be there, because they do pose a threat to him because they almost defeated him the first time.
Grab hands.
And that works in the book, but because of the way we're telling the story now in the two separate films, this Pennywise, he really wants them back. He's missed them.
Thank you for bringing them all back. I can smell their fear.
I know what you are. That's why I'm not afraid.
Obviously, that would make for a pretty boring movie if all they do is, oh, this is what we did the first time and did this exact same thing. So for me, it was really important that Pennywise needs to be this sort of arch villain.
Oh, I know what you are, a madman.
He needs to be scary and he needs to be threatening. So that was one of the challenges that we had to address.
I used Pennywise as a door opener for all the other things that these kids are scared of. And Andy made the right decision to actually broaden the scope, and the kids see transformations of Pennywise that are his own artistic creations, but they still relate to the various fears and phobias of the kids.
This is Vince Prose. Vince is helping me to bring my nightmares to life, and he's throwing a lot of his nightmares in, and it's quite scary.
We have a version of Pennywise where they're weakening him and he starts to deflate. So Andy wanted him to be almost like a deflating balloon.
You're all grown up.
Andy comes up with these ideas that once you see it and once it's implemented, it's just like, oh, this is crazy, this is genius.
I like the fact that I'm trying to convince myself that I'm the hero.
Yeah, let's do that, absolutely.
Yeah.
But you're also broken. You're broken.
Yeah.
Like a cockroach on rain.
Clown! The idea was to get a small child to play the body part of Bill.
Clown!
And then we had a replica of the kid's body. And that was known as Pancake Head.
This is what is known in Stephen King's universe as the Ritual of Chud. And the Ritual of Chud is when you staple intergalactic entity's head to a piece of volcanic. Just like that. It worked.
Finally, he becomes the spider.
It's the end of the battle. And the first one we had, like, Pennywise as me. We needed to up that, you know? Like, they're adults. The physicality needs to be more threatening. So Andy came up with this creature that he essentially drew, which is my face, a gigantic Pennywise face on this sort of spider-esque kind of body. Andy's so good with designing creatures.
I got the Pennywise spider. You want to see him?
Yeah. I really love this frame. Vince's contributions to the monster are really cool. You can see how he integrated the costume into the anatomy of the spider. But I also like the spirit of this drawing because it's grotesque and it's horrifying at the same time.
Now you're the one who's afraid.
At the end of the first movie, Pennywise for the first time feels fear himself. And that's why his last line in the movie is fear. It's him realizing what that feeling is.
Fear.
So he uses fear to sort of season the flesh, if you will. And he instills fear in children and in humans. But he never actually understood what that was because he's never felt it before himself. And I think that that is scary for him, but it's also a thrill. So there's a craving. He craves the losers that are now adults. Because if this creature and this entity has lived for millions and millions of years, it's a high to have an opponent that's matched him. I feel like the way this movie ends, at least from my perspective and the character, he plants things and there's reasons for why things are happening. And when the kids that are now adults, when they think they're in control, they're actually not in control. And this is really scary. If you talk about Pennywise's own subconscious or its own subconscious, maybe wants to die or it wants to cease to exist. So at the very end of this movie, maybe that was his goal all along. And in that sense, Pennywise wins.